Hello friends, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make mixed fruits vinegar. I have plenty of vinegar making videos, but mostly I have used single fruit. But today I'm going to show you how you can make mixed fruits, especially if you have overripe fruits at home, you can use those. So right now I have these fruits which are overripe and I'm going to use them to make vinegar. Overripe fruits are best for making vinegar because they contain higher percentage of alcohol than normal fruits. I have cut these fruits into small pieces and now I'm going to add this in the sterilized jar. Today I'm using orange, green apples, banana, mango, red apples and star fruit. We'll add the fruits inside the jar first and then we will add the water. The whole vinegar making process we can divide into two phases. In phase 1, we are trying to create alcohol with the help of yeast. And in the second phase, we are trying to convert this alcohol to acetic acid with the help of bacteria, which is called acetobacter. And the acetic acid we consider as vinegar. Most of the fruits are very sweet, so I'm not going to use a lot of sugar. I will only use 5% sugar of total water I'm using here. Since we are not using the wine or commercial yeast to do the fermentation, we are depending on the wild yeast which is present on the fruit skin and also in the air. So we have to protect the yeast also. That's why we can't give too much sugar on the first day, then it will be difficult for yeast to break down the sugar. But also to survive, the yeast needs food time to time, and that's why we will add sugar every day or every alternate day, because sugar or sucrose is the food for yeast. Also make sure you are not using tap water which might have chlorine or chemicals which can make yeast weak, and it's better to use organic fruit so that you will have active yeast on the fruit skin. If we provide right environment, the yeast will break down the sugar and the fermentation will start and the alcohol will be created as the byproduct of fermentation. To get good vinegar, we need good alcohol. I already told you, because to get vinegar, you need the alcohol. The acetobacter bacteria comes from the air and then they convert the alcohol to vinegar. So I will keep this jar in the room temperature and every day or every other day I will open the jar and I will add 1 spoon sugar so that yeast will have sufficient food to do the fermentation. And that's why I'm not going to airtight the jar. I have already taken out the rubber which makes it airtight. Also, you shouldn't airtight the jar because during the fermentation there will be carbonation, the carbon dioxide and gas will create and which can help the jar to explode. So this is the third day and in between I have given 1 spoon sugar on the second day and you can see a lot of bubbles inside. So basically yeast is breaking down the sugar and because of that inside the gas and the carbon dioxide building up, which means the fermentation is active now and because of that alcohol will be created, which is our primary objective. Today is 11th day. And the fruits were very sweet and that's why I didn't give the sugar every day. I have given 1 spoon sugar every alternate day and you can see a lot of bubbles are there. That means the fermentation is still very active. I'm adding 1 more spoon sugar again and I will continue doing this until 2 weeks. After that I will stop, because in these 2 weeks yeast will create decent amount of alcohol and after that yeast can't survive, because when the alcohol percentage is high, yeast also die off. So no point adding sugar after that if it is no more active. If you still continue to add sugar, your vinegar will be sweet because there will be no yeast to convert that sugar to alcohol. Today is day 26 and you can see there is a very thin layer on top, just like a young coconut, and this one we call mother. So when we say the vinegar is with mother, that means there is good bacteria present, and when the good bacteria called acetobacter present in your vinegar, they create this layer which we call also mother. So this mother only forms when there is decent amount of alcohol in your vinegar. When you see the mother is forming, don't airtight the jar. Keep a cloth or kitchen towel to close the mouth. Today is 1 month completed. I recommend people to strain the fruits after 3 to 4 weeks, but I couldn't do that. Before that, the mother started forming on the vinegar. So I have just left it. So when you see there is no activity going on, no bubbles and fruits went down, you can strain the vinegar. If you notice mother started forming before you strain, don't disturb the mother, just leave it like that. If you get good alcohol during the fermentation, you will get mother faster. Otherwise it might take longer to get the mother. 45 days over, and you can see how the vinegar color changed over time. So previously it was quite cloudy, now you can see very transparent, and there is one layer which we call mother at the bottom. Because I was continuously moving this jar for shooting, and that's why the mother went down. But there is one more mother formed on top, you can see. So if you see mother is forming, don't disturb the mother. So with this pH strip, I'm going to do a pH level test. Generally, if the pH level is below 3 to 4, we can consider the vinegar is ready. I'll take little vinegar and I will soak the pH strip there, and you can see the color almost changed, and it's matching with this reddish brownish color, which is around 3. So it could be 3.5, or it could be 3.2, or it could be 3.8. So if you want exact number, you can use the pH meter instead of pH strip. Just to inform, pH level varies vinegar to vinegar. That means depend on which fruits vinegar you are measuring, and also based on the brands, which brands meter you are using, also based on that your pH level can differ. Look at the vinegar here, so transparent, and the color is so beautiful. Since I have not used any one particular fruit, the color is totally different from the apple cider vinegar color. This is little bit yellowish. Also, I have some lighting issues, but generally in the whole process, vinegar color will change from phase 1 to phase 2, and also with the time. My vinegar is almost ready, but I will still keep 3 to 4 weeks. Right now, I want to strain. So I'm taking out the mother first, but this mother actually broke, because this mother is comparatively new. So if you notice that your mother went down, don't worry, you will get a new mother on top again. Internet is full of misleading information. Lot of videos will show you the sediment at bottom and tell you this is the mother, but that's not the mother. Mother is on the top. You see this layer, and this layer is formed by the bacteria called Acetobacter, which we call the probiotic or good bacteria, and that's also called mother. So mother is the bacteria, and the mother is the layer formed by the bacteria. Both we call mother. Since we already got the layer on top, so we know that Acetobacter present in this vinegar, and that's why we can call this liquid vinegar with mother. I have taken this clean cloth, and I'm going to strain the vinegar now, and I will put in a narrow mouth bottle. Choosing right bottle is very important for vinegar making process. Different stage you need different kind of bottle. At the initial stage, you can use the airtight bottle or airtight jar with wide mouth. Once your fermentation is over and you are going to strain the fruits, always remember to put the liquid in a wide mouth jar so that you get more oxygen, because the Acetobacter comes from the air, and that's why you can't airtight. You have to put a kitchen towel on top so that the air can pass easily. But when your vinegar is almost ready, you need to put it in a narrow mouth bottle so that it will be not exposed to oxygen much. Having more exposure to oxygen can actually spoil your vinegar. Since most of the fruits were overripe, you can see nothing left much due to the fermentation. Most of the fruits are mashed already. I have taken out the transparent portion from the jar to this narrow mouth bottle, and now I'm going to add this cloudy liquid also. After some time, the sediment will fall down at the bottom, and the whole thing will be transparent again. I have taken this bottle so that I can keep the bottle full, so that there will be little space left for the oxygen exposure. Acetobacter bacteria already converted the alcohol with the help of oxygen to acetic acid, which we call vinegar. So once our vinegar is ready, we don't need the oxygen anymore. There is some extra vinegar left, so I'm going to keep this mother and the vinegar together in the jar. So if you want to keep the mother, you have to put it in little vinegar so that it will be active, and you can use this mother for your next batch. So always remember, don't airtight your mother, you have to put the kitchen towel only. And this mother will help you to get your next batch faster. So here is our mixed food vinegar, almost ready, but I'm going to keep it for 3 to 4 weeks more in the room temperature. Today is 2 months over, and you can see the color of the vinegar is totally different. Right now the color is very shiny and little transparent, and also dark. The sediments of the liquid also went down. The longer you keep in room temperature, the vinegar color will be darker and the pH level will be lower. That's good, but I suggest after 3 to 4 months, put the vinegar in your refrigerator so that it will not have much oxygen exposure, and the chances of vinegar getting spoiled will be lower. So my mixed food vinegar is ready, and I'm going to start consuming it. If you like this video, comment below, give me a thumbs up, press the subscribe button with the bell button, and I see you again with lots of fermented food and drinks recipes. Stay happy and healthy.